Welcome. In this tutorial, I will briefly describe sampling distribution of the sample mean and also calculate probabilities based on the normal distribution. Consider a population consisting of these four values. The mean of this population is 5.25 and the population standard deviation is 2.165. Now, suppose we select all possible samples of size 2 with replacement from this population and compute the sample mean x bar for each sample. This is now a distribution of sample means. We find that the mean of this sample means is 5.25, which is the same as the mean of the original population. And the population standard deviation of the sample means is 1.531, which is equal to the population standard deviation divided by the square root of the sample size used, which is 2, that is, sigma over square root of n. In essence, the mean of the sampling distribution of sample means will always equal the population mean, and the standard deviation of the sample means, also called standard error, will equal the population standard deviation divided by the square root of n. Now we have the central limit theorem, which basically says that as the sample size increases, the sampling distribution of the sample means will approach a normal distribution. That is, if the population is normal, then the distribution of sample means will also be normal. And if the population is not normal, the distribution of sample means becomes approximately normal when n is large. And by large, we often say when n is at least 30. Now, recall that an individual score x in a normal population is standardized using x minus mu over sigma. To standardize the mean of a sample of size n, we replace x by x bar and change the standard deviation to the standard error of the mean. Let's look at an example. Given a normal population with a mean of 63 and a standard deviation of 12, we want to find the probability that a random sample of size 16 has a mean greater than 61.5. Note that we have a sample here with sample size provided, and we're finding the probability for a sample mean and not for an individual score. So we can apply the Z formula for sampling distribution of the mean. The standard error is 12 divided by root 16, which gives 3. So the Z score is 61.5 minus 63 divided by 3, which gives negative 0.5. Looking that up in the less than cumulative normal table, we have a less than area of 0.3085. So the greater than area is 1 minus 0.3085, which gives 0.6915. That is, the probability that the sample mean is greater than 61.5 is 0.6915. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.